Welcome to Advent of Code. Today, as tradition goes, we are solving a task that was left incomplete in 2018. Some maze, apparently. This looks visual, so we can use visuals and use Humble UI. Yay! Let me create a day for it. Maybe from it's called day what? Day 22. Okay. Day 22. Okay. We go here. We make new. We say 22. There is puzzle input somewhere. Okay, probably don't need it. Where is my input here? I don't see the input. Okay, yeah, that's This is it, your final stop, the year minus 483, it's snowing and dark outside, the only light you can see. Yeah, I started recording, right? I am recording, yeah, I'm recording. It's snowing and dark outside, your only light is coming from a small cottage, in the distance you make your way there and knock on the door. Portly man with a large white beard answers the door and invites you inside. So someone living near the North Pole in minus 483. He must not get many visitors, but he doesn't act surprised to see you. Instead, he offers you some milk and cookies. After talking for a while, he asks, already day 22. Yeah, but it's 2018. I like things to be complete, and I'm only 4 days off from like seeing the whole picture. So. I already did day 9, so. Blah, blah, blah. The cave is divided into square regions, which are either dominantly rocky, narrow, or wet, called its type. Each region occupied exactly one coordinate in XY format, where X and Y are integers and 0 or greater. Adjacent regions can be the same type. The scan of your puzzle input is not very detailed. It only reveals the depths of the cave system and the coordinates of the target. However, it doesn't reveal the type of each region. The mouse of the cave is 00. The man explains that due to unusual geology in the area, geology, I don't know.
Geology.
Okay. The erosion level of a region can be determined from a geologic index. The geologic index can be determined using the first rule that applies from the list below. The region at 0, 0 has an index of 0. The region at the coordinates of the target has index of 0. If the region's y coordinate is 0, the index is its x coordinate times blah blah. What? So we know like top and we know left. Otherwise, the region's geologic index is the result of multiplying the erosion levels of the region's x minus 1. So we go. Okay, region erosion level is the geologic index plus the cave system's depths, all modulo. Okay, for example, suppose the cave system depth is 5, 10 and the target's current is 10, 10. Okay, so I guess this is the input, right? Depth and target. So we don't need parse. Depth 510. X10. We can call it target 10, 10. Should probably do something for like for this, like a method to like add them. Yeah, what, actually, why not? Why shouldn't I, right? We just needed something like this. Let's call this 2D. Can I start this number? Let's call it points, right? Vector. Let's call it vector. Yeah, I like vector. Vector. Okay, so what else do we need? Zero, right? So div zero is gonna be v2 zero zero. And stuff like neighbors and top left, right, bottom. Yeah, maybe actually. You know, left. Actually, this is decrement, this is increment. Top. Maybe we can put, actually, you know what? We should use add. Yeah, this is much better. Let's call it V2 actually. And this is going to be called make. I guess we don't need type hints here. Okay, and we have also our neighbors 8, which is gonna be 4 of those. And 1, 1, 1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1. Okay, so do this connect what? Okay, yeah. Okay, so now we have this on day 22 is we are going to do advent of coder v2 right? Okay, so maybe you know what? I probably want still want this, but like this. Okay. Okay. So we have this. yeah. Let's do this. Okay. We have this. That's nice. What's next? So we know the formula. We know how it is calculated, right? Drawing the same system as rock is right. Well, but before you go, I should risk level is here for the things that is a problem. Juice meet upfield in green is raiding with a party of 7. Oh, hi guys. We are coding closure and advent of code, I guess. So, welcome. Light mode. Yeah. I'm a professional programmer, so I use light mode. For the rectangle, that's top left corner region and bottom corner region getting its target, and vertical elevation is 0 for rocky, 1 for wet, and 2 for narrow. Rocky, wet, and narrow, okay. And the target is 10, adding up the risk level of regions that takes from 0 to 10, this total is 114. Okay. Now advent of code light. So we need to basically calculate this, right? This is a 2D array. 2D array that is filled like diagonally. It's interesting. We can fill it line by line, actually. Yeah. Yeah, we can fill it line by line, and okay. So we don't need parse because why would we need parse? I guess right. So yeah, let's write the solution. So the first thing we do is. I guess we allocate array. How do we solve it? I guess we allocate array, right? Right. I guess we make a loop that starts with map, right? Or I don't know, M, let's call it M. So the first one is gonna be, yeah, we're probably gonna need depth and target. We build first row, I guess. Oh my god, how do you make it? No, okay, yeah. Let with be ink as target, right? So this is our width, and we also have height, which is going to be So if it's a 10-10, that means 11 by 11, right? Right. Map is basically, let's call it erosion, right? Or let's call it erosions. What was that? What was that? Let's call it erosions. And it's gonna be vec of repeat. So we start with this, right? And then we basically update it. Yeah, this is inefficient as hell. let's make a mutable array. We have make array enclosure, right? Make array. Make array type line. Okay, so make array type integer type. So basically, we want ints, probably yes. With height. Okay, so this is and then we go x, we go y range 0 height, x range 0 width, asset erosions. Erosions XY, right? X right with right. Okay, but anyways, erosion XY with right. Okay, so case, or basically can count x equals 0, right? So what does it mean? If the region's y coordinate is 0, if the region's x coordinate is 0, multiply y by if they are both 0, if the okay, and otherwise as a result of multiplying the levels of region x minus 1 y and x y minus 1. Okay. Else, result of multiplying. Okay, so multiply erosions deck x y okay, this is of course wrong and we have to do this. Kind of, right? And this is index, basically. And erosion level is index plus cave systems depth, all modular. We need depth in here as well. P plus index depth modulo this. Okay. We need to pass depth in here. Okay. Kind of like this, right? I think I'm going to rename this. Okay, now what? We basically want okay, yeah, now that's correct. Index is 0, type is okay. So now we basically have to sum everything and module tree, right? Okay, so now we do the same. Oh. I forgot to specify the index, so it's plus x, y, multiply this. Still, let's print ln string join slash n partition widths. Okay, yeah. Yo, Advent of Code, yeah, we're solving year 2018. What's wrong now? Did it print anything? I see a lot of warnings here. We probably want something like this. Like, did we get rid of warnings? No. No, it doesn't know that erosions is ints. Now we kind of solved it, but we're getting now point of exception, and there is no indication what it doesn't like. Yeah, let's restart. Maybe we need a get here. No. So depth is new. Oh, yeah, of course. Of course, of course. So 114, is it correct? It is correct. I forgot print somewhere, like here. Why is it printing lazy 6? What's lazy? Drawing. Yeah, okay, whatever. You know what? Yeah, we can get something like this, but it's, it doesn't really matter. Let's comment this out. One for what? Oh yeah, we don't have data. Yeah. We have data and data is, this is our depth and this is our target. The right answer, yahoo! Okay, but the second part I imagine. Now the real challenge begin. Okay, it's time to go rescue the man's friend. As you leave, he hands you some tools, a torch and some climbing gear. You can't equip both tools at once, but you can choose to use neither. Tools can only be used in certain regions. In rocky regions, you can use the climbing gear or the torch. You cannot use neither. You'll likely slip and fall. Climbing gear or torch. In wet regions, you can use the climbing gear or neither tool. You cannot use torch. If it gets wet, you'll have a light source. Yeah, logical. In narrow regions, you can use torch or neither tool. You cannot use climbing gear, it's too bulky to fit. Okay, whatever. You start 0-0 miles of the cave with the torch equipped and must reach the target coordinates as quickly as possible. The regions with negative X or Y are solid rocks, rock and cannot be traversed. The fastest route might involve entering regions beyond the X or Y coordinate of the target. That's very bad. that's very, very bad. You can move to adjacent region, up, down, left, or right, never diagonally. If you currently equip a tool, allows you to enter that region. Moving to an adjacent region takes 1 minute. For example, if you have the torch equipped, you can move between rocky and narrow regions, but cannot enter wet regions. You can change your currently equipped tool or put both away if your new equipment would be valid for your current region. Switching to using the climbing gear, torch, and neither. Always takes 7 minutes, regardless of which tools you start with. For example, if you are in a rocky region, okay, whatever. Now, finally, once you reach the target, you need the torch equipped before you can find him in the dark. The target is always in a rocky region, so if you arrive there with climbing gear equipped, you will need to spend 7 minutes switching to a torch. For example, using the same cave as above, starting in the top left corner and moving to the bottom right corner, like that, then as quickly as possible. One possible route is as follows: with your current position mark X, down, right, switch from using torch to neither tool, right, switch from neither tool to the climbing gear, down, down, whatever. This is tied with other routes as the fastest way to reach target is 45 minutes. In it, 21 minutes are spent switching tools 3 times, 7 minutes each, and the remaining 24 minutes are spent moving. What is the fewest number of minutes you can take to reach the target? That's very hard to tell. Oh my god, this is super annoying. Well, not annoying, but this is a proper problem. Yeah, wow. Okay, at least we'll probably can do some visualizations, right? Okay. Okay, I think this calls for a cup of tea, so 1 minute break. Okay. Hopefully you can hear me. Yes, it shows. So, what are our options? So actually, we don't really care about erosions, right? We care about what's 760, right? Yeah, that's deep. It's a very deep cave, actually. So this is what I'm thinking. We start flooding it from the top left, and we move like outside. Always check our neighbors, and if you find like a faster path somewhere, we use it, right? Now, the problem is that it's unbounded on the right and on the bottom. That's unfortunate. How tall is my screen? It's like 900, right? So. Yeah. Okay, whatever. I say we built a visualization of it. Let's look in the data. I'm not using this. So we need kind of something like this. What happened? Genshin K1 followed me. Yay! Hey, Genshin K1. We need something like this. Yeah. Let's insert it here. Let's let's define terrain. Let's probably def once make array. So should it be an array? I'm not sure. You know what? I am in a mood for creating a new map. Purple lungs because okay, so it's a mutable map with some methods. Okay. Okay. Okay, so we have the import map. We don't need yet. Well, probably would want this eventually. Yeah. So what we do is map make with height, right? Then basically do seek like this. You know what, I probably want it like this. write map get res like x, y. Okay. So this is our index. That next is the erosion is going to be like this. Map set res okay, something like this. Then we go like this again, but now we do map set res xy mod map get res xy 3. Okay, so we basically replace it and we return res soc res target. Okay, so our map neighbor, oh, I have depths as well. Okay, something is not working here, right? What's wrong? No, terrain seems to work. So part one, probably, right? So like part one now is gonna be terrain depths. Target, we to add target like this, right? Finally, we are getting null pointer exception. Cool. Do we get now? let's don't do that right now. Okay, cool. Okay, so yes, we figure this out. Yes. Yeah, so we have something, please write. And still we get multiply xy. Okay, so let's print. Print ln x, y, and x, and there are from here. What is null? I don't understand what, like, x, y. Like, we get it on 43. 43 is here. Oh, okay. Yeah, this is our problem, actually. What's wrong now? I guess now it works again. Okay, so we made it work again. We made a function called terrain that does what it does, whatever it does, right? Okay. Yeah, and now maybe we want to draw it. Let's see. Let's define maybe div one's terrain, and it's gonna be terrain. Well, let's call it make terrain depth target size from data, right? Make terrain. Okay, make terrain data. Data. So we add extra 100 to both sides. Okay, so this is our terrain. It's actually called make terrain. Okay, let's see. Yeah, one day here. Yeah, this is bad. Let's print the line somewhere. Okay, we have some visuals. Not sure. Yeah, I guess this triggers visuals, right? And our task is like we have terrain here. Terrain is probably we want modified, right? We want modified. So let me remind regions. Rocky, wet, narrow. Rocky. Wet. Narrow. So this has to be blue, right? So rocky should be maybe gray, and narrow should be what? Red? Okay, yeah, let's do this. Let's draw. So we uncomment this, basically. With size, row, please, let's state. Okay, we don't need this, but so we do like y moves from range 0 to h terrain, okay? X moves from 0 to width terrain, okay? So this basically centers it. This we don't need this at all. Okay, so this more or less draws what we need to draw, okay? Okay, this is our map, more or less. The actual map is very narrow on the left, like 1/10 of it. Should I split it? Probably should, right? Okay, let's say we use this or like this. Okay, so this is our terrain, 100 by 1000. So what we do is, let's say we split it, call range 0, 5, right? Like this, Y, and in this case, kind of like this, but we do this because we can make much bigger in this case. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so 5 don't fit, right? Well, kind of fit, but let's choose better colors. Like boom, boom, boom. Is like one of them is harder than other or what? The first two. Okay, no, they're not one. Like it's always two. Okay, so it doesn't matter. So basically, we're just looking at three distinct colors that like play nice together. I'm not sure, but let's try. This is rocky. This is, and this is probably red. Yeah. This looks slightly better, right? So you know what? We probably are going to split by 4. Calls for calls. Yeah, so it starts from top left and goes down. Okay. So this is our terrain. So what? So now what we are going to do is, we are going to build a map of costs of traversing this terrain, right? It's interesting because it also depends like which which gear you get to each point. Yeah. Yeah, it's very interesting. it's probably a very long task. So basically what I'm thinking is we build the same map, basically. Let me resize it and put it in the center, right? Okay. I build the same size map, and basically for each point we keep a score, like how costly is this to get there with particular type of gear, right? And from each point, we essentially can do, we can do four moves, up, down, left, and right, and we can change gear in two directions. So from each point, we have like a branching factor of six. Right. Probably terrible. so yeah, what I'm trying to think about is like, would our search work this way or not? Would it work at all, basically? Okay. So the way I'm thinking of this would work is we define scores. Can we put three numbers in a single? Like, our target is at this current, so it's basically 800, right? 800 times 20 times 7 minutes, like if we like 8 minutes, it's just 6,400. So basically, six 400 takes, it's like short. So you need like, this is not enough, but this is enough. So we need 16 bits, right? 16 bits is 16 bits. Oh, we can put 16 bits actually. the reason I'm thinking about it, like, we have gear, the gear is what? Let's call it gear, torch, neither, right? Gear, torch, neither. Map make with 200,000. Well, okay, yeah, okay. Scores gear, scores torch, and scores neither. Okay. Actually, you know what? Would be cool if we can put. Yeah. No, you know what? Let's just make a method called fill. And this basically returns your map, but kind of like this, okay? So we can fill this let's fill it with 10k, right? Because objectively our worst is, yeah, it's probably not worse than this. Okay, what? Okay, so this kind of works. Terrain demo for TDF once, so this doesn't, this won't change, really. This could, okay, so gear towards neither. Now, what we are going to do, like, we know that cost of getting to the 0, 0 is what we start. We start with torch, okay, cool. So we know that map set scores torch, right? V2000. So oops. So the cost to get there with torch is 0. Okay, does it work? It works. What? Why is it so slow, actually? Is this slow? Why is it slow? Like, setting this is slow? Is it slow? What? Oh, I didn't know that this is long. Okay. Now it's fast. Okay, yes, that's closure for you. That's closure for you. Oh, yeah. Okay, so we have some scores, right? And we have, what we are going to do is actually we are going to define Q, and Q is, it's actually a vector, whatever, with and yeah, kind of like this. Actually, you know what? You know what? You know what? You know what? Actually, with scores, we are going to make it gear, torch, and none. Yeah, something like this, and set returns map, right? So basically torch map set v2 0 0 0 like this. Okay. Yeah, we're actually gonna do this. This is our queue. So basically this is a boundary that we are going to do. And the way it works is so if we have this, right? Kind of. So if we have this, we have six more possible positions. Let cost of our move. No, wait, what? Okay, so this is our position, right? Yeah, let's do mutable everything. pick Q, right? Our possible moves are okay, let's make it a vector, right? So we can make probably have torch first everywhere. Okay, so when some okay you know what we need to contains when map contains okay let pause equip move oh, we can actually don't have to do it like this, right? Some pause or there. Map contains terrain. So we still inside, right? Finally, if it's allowed. And it's allowed if so Rocky is climbing gear or torch or and during pause when or equals T. So 0, which is Rocky, right? Rocky wet narrow, okay. Rocky wet we need and so on Rocky, what we allowed to gear or torch? Okay. On wet, gear or neither? Okay. Gear, we call it none, so none. And narrow, torch or neither. Okay. So that's the next condition. And finally, we need cost as well. Yeah, this, there is a cost somewhere. And cost is 1, 1, 1, 1, 7, 7, 7, right? Seven minutes, 1 minute. Okay, cool. Yeah, so this is our cost. Finally, when let so score, our score was at this position. Map get equip scores or scores equip. This is a map that we want to check, right? And finally position. And current score. The new score will be where we are, we were standing, plus the cost of moving or changing, right? So, and when it's smaller, strictly smaller, right? We basically want to yeah, let's do it immutable way. So this is our queue, right? We do this, then we do reduce. This is what we do reduce over. So this is possible moves, right? This is the sequence over which we reduce. We start with queue. And here we take Q and pause equip cost, right? And basically we move all this. And this is basically nil pause just Q. If it's outside of map, we don't want to go there, basically. Count plus, right? If you're stepping on gear equip, actually, pause equip and it's basically like this. And T is basically terrain is global in our case. Not allowed, new pose, new equip queue. All right. We still need score, kind of. You know what? This should be pop Q like this. Conch Q pause equip. All right. And we actually because we found it. It's okay. Oh, it's a mess. It's like. It's partially mutable, partially immutable. Yeah, it's a mess, but well, advent of code is always a mess, right? So, okay. We want to set, oops, sorry, scores equip pause score. Okay, this is our step, kind of. At least it compiles, right? Let's see. Let's see our queue. Can it be? Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, swap Q step. Wait, what? So now Q is 1 0 torch 0 1 torch. Okay, so I'm thinking this, so on paint, right? We want to paint Q actually. Do seek pause Q. What? White? Okay. Okay. Right. Transparent white. Whatever. Pose is K6. Call. What's call? So X to CX. Oh, So we take this x, y, right? Let call quad y this column, right? Okay, so it starts exploring something, but of course it's very slow, right? Yeah, we're not going to do this. Let's stop this. You know what? I'm going to put redraw right here so it redraws constantly, and we are going to do this when a while. There's something happening. Yeah, but the door is not. For some reason. It's not happening. Where are we? Okay, Q changes. Right. Let me set it to much more non-transparent. But for some reason, redraw is not affecting it. And now I have no idea what is jumping. Yeah, no, this is... possible. Okay, I think you know what? I think that colors should be much more... much more neutral like this tree. Like maybe copy this one. Green for, I don't know, for wet, yellow for narrow, and brown for rocky, brown is too, maybe this one, no, green is too dark. Yeah, kind of like this, but and Q is gonna be like 80 000 000 000 like this. Okay. What if I print redraw? That is redrawing, right? Constantly. Okay, cool. How long does it take? But anyways, not printing. No. And now we run this. Okay, so this is depth something search. We also should probably cover somehow how much we have already covered. Really, but this is like unguided, right? Should be guided, probably, like priority queue. Like I can put priority queue for like as how close are we to the target? Maybe that would do something. I hope it's not looping. That's what concerns me actually. You know what? Yeah, let's also do this. Okay. Stop. Okay, so it's kind of filling up. Looks cool too. I should probably what now? Well, this displays at least one, right? Okay, we do this, we do this, reset all scores. Now we see this. Well, it's like some score, right? I probably need priority map, and I also need probably to print somewhere. Okay, yeah, cancel this. Not sure what this is about. Okay, so you know what? Let's do this. Canvas draw string. Canvas LG. No, canvas LG. Draw string. Canvas XY font. Canvas 2020 font. Font UE CTX. Paint. Oh, string goes here. What we need is we need torch, right? Torch. Okay. So we need torch. Torch scores for V2, well, target date, right? Right. Like this. Like this. No, it's not visible. Well, it should at least draw 10,000, right? I don't see it. Why am I not seeing it? Wonder. Should I actually cache terrain? Should probably cache terrain. Nah. What's with the text? Seeing text. Yeah, it's all nice and cool and stuff, but okay, yeah, now I can see it. What if I make 2020? Okay, probably 1040. Ah, 2040. Okay. Okay, so this is our score, right? Let's Q. Okay, yeah. Let's see. So somehow score gets smaller. Well, I'm not sure how. Because it's over here. No. It's like constantly finding better paths there. Yeah, we need priority queue probably. Good news is we have priority queue actually. Priority map. Well, priority map is kind of the same, right? Actually, I think sorted set is enough. Okay, we probably need know what? I also want to draw a target actually. The target I want to draw as this. Okay, so target is here. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Wait, what? Why is it so huge then? Okay, so target is here. Persistent reset. Okay. Okay, so this is priority, and we found something, right? Some path. Feeling this. Okay, and it's getting smaller and smaller. One, five, nine. Too high, okay, yeah, whatever. Too high, so, you know what? This might be a problem with right, so it might be that we need like terrain like this. Am I using the ones for terrain? Clobe followed me. Hi, Clobe. We reset everything, right? if once. Oh no, not everything, but looks like yeah, whatever. Like, it doesn't make much sense to draw terrain really, right? So let's just skip this part. Where is our red dot? Okay, so it's here. So what happens if we run our algorithm right now? So we can go to the left, right? But we can go as far right as we want. And it said 15 meters. It was too high. So it's totally possible that there exists like a shorter path somehow. No. Okay. No, but we can check. We can check, really. We can check with, so let's say terrain goes from sample, right? And sample is 10 by 10, so let's make it 100 by 100. What? What is array index out of bounds exception? So, like, for some reason, at some point, closure starts to, like, stops giving you. But we don't have like anything. Oh, because we no. Yeah, I know. Data, yeah, like this. Yeah, now it works. We can even draw terrain, I think, even with bigger. I guess, okay, so let's run our function and see what results it gives us. 62. What result it should have given us? 45. So something went wrong, right? Something is not working. That's clear, I think. I wonder why it stops, right? Why doesn't it go like outside or something? Like, why doesn't it go here? It can be that it's like, maybe it can't go, right? There could be like boundaries, like strict boundaries, because you can't always go from one to another. Right. No, you can always go from one to another. Like from Rocky, you can go to this with climbing, you can go to this with torch. From this, you can go to here. No, you can always go. Why it stops then? Does it stop? I don't understand. Should we print like for scores for torch? I don't know. Do seek range. Okay, so at 0, 10,000 restore, but like basically it means you can't go here with torch, which is all right. Here, let's say we want something like this. Okay, and then it starts with thousands. Like, why not go here, for example? I don't understand. It stops. Okay, let's rent. If position is nil, knock nil is. Maybe allowed is wrong. So terrain only has three values, right? Otherwise it would break here. So terrain is probably okay. Ish. Yeah, it's nice. It looks nice. So we can go left, right, top and bottom. Is it top and bottom or up and down? Yeah, probably up and down is better. With the equips that we have, or we can change staying. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 options. This is where we are going, and current score of that position, right? This is where we are at. Plus this. And if our score is equal, or well, maybe if we remove equal from here, it will be better. It feels more thorough. It's not improving our main result, actually. Not removing it, improving it at all. It's even worse. Why is it worse? Something is wrong. Yeah, it's probably very wrong because yeah, I know what why it's wrong. Yeah, I know what's wrong. Basically, if you stay and I do screen, yeah, like this. Yeah, I know what's wrong. Like, it won't change on this to step to the right, for example, right? Because because it's more expensive, basically. it doesn't anticipate like the next move. Well. Like, no. No, 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 that's not it. Like, if we at some point, right, and we need to go right, but we have to change equipment for that. Maybe I misunderstood the. No. If there's price for that agreement already, that means that we've been there. Maybe it has to do with this somehow, that we mutate scores and cure. No, I don't see how I'm wrong. Let's do It's hard to comprehend. What if target function, like I'm using 7 here, what if I change it for 0? Will it change anything or not? And we need 45, right? Why changing target function, like our scoring function? Actually, the only thing it should change is, we're doing something wrong, actually. We're doing something really, really wrong. It should change the order in which like this walk happened, but it shouldn't change the result, basically. Should I print scores or like how should I approach this? This is okay-ish, right? But we can do, for example, so right now it's 10. Can I do 100? Kind of, right? 100. Okay, yeah. Then at each point, I can, in theory, So target is always Rocky, right? Climbing gear, torch gear, torch 55 gears, of course. So, okay, but there is none, for example. Can keep torch here. Can equip this. Like, charge this approach. Let's do it differently. I don't think we need 100 by 100. How big is this? Like 20 by 20 should be enough, right? Yeah, okay. Let's do step by step, actually. Well, so the cost of this is 0. The cost of this is 1. Or 7 if we stay here, right? Right. Now, the cost of here is 2. The here cost could be 8. If you change, yeah, if you don't change it, or 2 here, yeah, that makes sense. Okay, now we can change here to 9, or is this on boundary still? And from 9 we can go here, 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 right? How do I? First of all, this seems 25, 50, 75, 100, okay? Okay. So now we have 10 here, here, here. Okay, I probably don't need, this thing. Okay. I don't remember which allows for which. So maybe I. How do I do this? Let's just continue, maybe we'll see where our mistake is. Okay, so we can change to 17 here, or we can go with 11 here. What about these two? I guess it's not on the border yet. Did I comment this out? Visited strings. I still draw Q, right? Okay, yeah. Okay, so this is our Q. Basically, we can go here with 12. Is there some, I don't know, cost analysis down right here? Which one is a torch to Nizer? 9, 10. How long is this? Okay, let's say I actually let this calculate, right? And now let's follow this. We go down with 1. Okay. True. Actually, you know what? We go down with 1. Okay, we go right with 2. Okay, now switch to neither. So we here with 9. We go right 3. So we were here 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So it's 12, right? 12 here. Switch from neither to climbing gear. We have 19 now. Then we go down with 7. 1, 2. Okay, we can't go here for some reason. Well, clearly this should be possible, right? So we can go, like, you see, we go here, we go 22, but here we don't go 22, but we can. So this is not covered for some reason. Okay, let's, now that we know what we're looking for, let's reset and see where this mistake happens. Yeah, whatever. At some point we should start from this, right? Yeah, we exhaust all the options. Okay, we exhaust this option. I'm not sure why are they exhausting now, but we found our 55 actually. Yeah, this I get, because like we've already been there probably with better scores, so yeah, this could be exhausting. Okay, this is our 32 thingy that we don't like. Okay, this looks like a proper A star, but something is really wrong with it. Like why did this died off? Like why didn't go here, for example? Okay, so right now we will take 43, right? 47. Well, yeah, probably this. Okay, and you know what? I want to see all the options, actually. Right. We have none. Okay, and I want to see all these options. Like this. Neil. What? What? It looks like a valid comment. Okay, so our options are go left with none. Go right with none. Probably this will probably die. Okay. Let's see. We are going pause, equip cost, map contains, allowed. Wait, no. Can it invoke what? Okay, so map contains true, they all contains allowed, only switching is not allowed. Okay, so we'll probably get Okay, actually, we can use, like, let's comment this out and let's call step on queue. Okay, I think that's it. Okay, yesterday we haven't finished the day 22 of 2018 because of stupid mistake, obviously, but I figured it after the fact, and yeah, now we can actually take a look. So the problem was that I was using sorted set with custom compare function right here, and turn out that it comp I imagine that sort it's like sorting an array, right? So when you find duplicate like elements sort the same, they just like kick up in any order. Instead, set just didn't order the second one, so like it treated them as equal if compare function was returning zero, which was unfortunate. Maybe we should have used priority map instead or something like that. But actually, priority map is probably not a bad idea in this case. So let's try. Let's try priority map. Yeah. Did I import it? No. But I probably want this. So with priority map. Yeah, sorted by value. So basically, we put what we want as value, right? Map. And basically, we don't need. Well, we need a cost function that takes pause equip, and essentially this. Cost function is going to be this. Okay, well, it's pause, and this is equip. Okay, now priority map slash priority map. Okay. And how do I specify the function? Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, this is important for us actually. Priority map by, okay. No, we don't need that, we actually, yeah. What's a constructor for priority map? You just case and values, okay. So in our case, this is a key and cost of n, or it is gonna be a value, right? Mm-hmm. So this is our Q. Well, its cost is going to be, well, no, that's correct. Where do we work? Okay, so here we use peak. We don't really care about value, right? And here we use pop. Kind of like this, right? Maybe eventually I'm going to do. Okay, what's about Q? I think that's it. That's all we need. Maybe here again, we don't care about radius. And we also need priority map. This is the key, and okay, let's run. Is we broke something or not? No, we didn't. Okay, and now I will show you how it was supposed to work. It's basically it was working fine actually, but yeah. So it found basically the way it works, it found it's the most straight way down to the target, right? Like the most straightforward, and now it tries to optimize it, and sometimes the optimization goes like a little bit even outside. So basically traveling here, somewhere here, is right now is cheaper than traveling here, which could be possible, sure, considering the cost of switching. Yeah, it's totally possible. But eventually, yeah, the score is in the bottom, and eventually when this reaches the top, it will stop. I also found that like you need at least 40 of extra space, but not more. I started at 100, but it was excessive, like you need it. Basically, yeah. You can see this triangle shape here. It's basically because of Manhattan distance, I guess, right? So like this and this are equally distant to the target, because you have from here you have to go walk left, and but from here you only have to go down. And we almost at the finish. Yeah, and that's it. So this is the score, this is the correct score. In fact, let me show you. Yeah, this is correct score, and that's how you solve it. I'm now thinking that maybe I need a priority queue in my library, which will be like priority map, but different. No, yeah, like priority map basically is a cost function, something like that. Priority queue, but only if they don't have something like that here, because yeah, this is a common mistake, actually. That's what I... Oh, wait. Oh. Yeah, this is almost what we need. We have set actually. Because set would be perfect in this case. And the problem with implementing my own would be like all those protocols that you have to. Nah, I don't want. Maybe eventually. There's just too many protocols to implement. Too many. Okay, we don't need this. Basically, the only optimization that I did is I also, if some point has score, like walking from that point to the target takes longer than the current score for target already, yeah, it's not worth it. That's on the optimization I added. If you don't need this. Okay, like, but yeah, I actually want a set that, let's make priority set, priority queue. No, let's make priority queue actually. Okay. Advent of code priority. I guess advent of code is kind of about kind of about having tools at your disposal, like useful tools, stuff like that. So we have closure, we have closure. Okay, so what we need is probably sorted set jar. It's, I guess it's called persistent reset. And yeah, we probably need what do we need? We can use let's do def record priority queue. It's gonna have cost of n and map. What's the now case M. Right. And it's gonna implement sort a lot of stuff like what's e obj for example. Meta. Yeah, we don't care about meta really. Sorted, what sorted does. It can return comparator, it can return entry key, sec, boolean. Yeah, probably don't need sorted. A persistent tree set. No, a persistent set. Okay. So it extends a fan. Yeah, I probably want a fan. Closure link. Well, I don't know. Let's, you know what, let's see what this is implementing. We can then, okay, a little break. Okay, I'm back. I look up. Probably not. Count. Sock. Nah, it's too boring. We can actually, you know what? We can cheat. And apply priority map, and here what we want to do is well, I guess it can be constructed from And we're going to remove conch, pop, and peak, right? Maybe this. And our basic idea is so conch x is gonna be conch actually a sock mx meta m cost of n meta m x, kind of like this, right? Disjoin mx is this sock. Basically, I'll pop this pop and peak is going to be different because and maybe keys as well, right? Well, yeah, pop is pop and this peak is going to be different because we need first peak. Because we're trying to make okay, so priority queue by cost of n and then this, right? Then this. Okay, then we have priority queue peak. Well, I guess I'm still not sure what to do with iterator, but I feel this reads a little bit better. Will it work, so let's find out. No. Yeah. Maybe this was wrong. No, this seems correct. So what's wrong? Step 182. Oh yeah, because now pick works as pick. I'm not sure what's wrong now, but and now I'm actually not sure why I can't switch to. Nothing really changed. No, something is wrong. Maybe we want also seek. Like this. In this case, we are going to do priority queue seek like this. Yeah, I know. I have pop here. I have pick here. It feels like actually. Okay, I'm doing way too much withdrawals somehow. Parents problem. Okay, so yeah, it works the same. It is hacky way to do this, but yeah, who cares, right? What else could we use? Like, yeah, priority queue, maybe. I was thinking that maybe you need some way to draw those maps. Like I have a map here, which is like 2D map, right? Maybe some way, universal way to draw it, and so I don't have to like calculate columns and stuff, but. Okay, maybe on the next task I will do this. Okay, yeah, let's commit this and probably end this video because it's been very, very long already. And we'll switch to today's task actually. And this is done. Let's stop.